always taking action for you.
We begin with breaking news right now. A huge fire involving HAZMAT teams.
Yeah, firefighters battling flames on the city's west side. That's where we find 7 Action News reporter Julie Bonovich. Julie, you can see this one from miles away.
You definitely could. I mean, we could see it while we were driving here, and I'll show you right here on the ground. You can just see how bad this fire is, and they have just upgraded this to a level 3 HAZMAT situation. Now, the lieutenant tells me they don't want to scare people, but they believe there could be chemicals in there. So what they want to do is, you can see these homes right next to where the fire is. That smoke is going up and over, and it's a huge residential neighborhood here. So they want people to close their doors and close their windows. Again, just to be on the safe side, the lieutenant from the fire department tells me they want people to close their doors and windows and to be inside. Don't stand out here breathing the smoke. So you can see live from Chopper 7 right now how large this area is, how large the area is, the residential area where all the smoke is going over. I talked with the lieutenant just minutes ago, and here's what he had to say about the fire. What do you guys know about the fire?
We don't know how it started right now. We're concerned with chemicals possibly being there, because we received some pictures earlier today from a resident about someone putting some drums or whatever inside. We don't know what's in the drums right now, so we're currently treating it as a HAZMAT situation.
Do you know if it's medical waste or anything like that?
I have no idea. At this point, we can't speculate or anything, so we have no idea, but we want to treat it as a HAZMAT situation right now.
Any evacuations going on?
No, right now we haven't been advised on evacuation. We have our HAZMAT crew on the scene, and if there will be an evacuation, we'll let the residents know. But right now, no form of evacuation.
Anybody hurt?
No one's been hurt yet.
Okay.
And hopefully not. I said, yeah, no one's been hurt yet.
Fire looks like it's still going pretty well. Do you guys have it under control? How do you get it under control?
It's pretty much contained. Well, thank you. We're very thankful that the wind is not being a factor currently. All the wind is taking the smoke and things out.
Now, here's the thing. A lot of people are wondering if this is coincidence or not. You heard the lieutenant talking about they believe there may be chemicals in here. We were actually also coming down here, and that's why we were already headed down this way to do a story with a neighborhood watch group, because they went inside and they saw that there were barrels of some kind labeled human waste, and they believed that people were dumping something medical in there. So they had called us, and we were just coming down here to meet them when this fire happened and erupted. So now they're raising serious questions. The fire department was also having a meeting about that same thing, because the residential group alerted them. Again, lots of questions being raised here. Again, people, if you are outside, get back in your homes. If you're just in this general area, close the doors and close the windows. Live from Detroit, Joanne and Jeff, back to you.
Well, Julie, I understand that there may be a coincidence there, but let's talk about the air quality. Is the EPA going to come out and test at any point in time to determine how safe it is to breathe the air?
Actually, Jeff, we're not quite sure. Actually, the lieutenant's back over here. Why don't we just ask him, Lieutenant?
Yes.
Will the EPA have to come out here at any point to determine whether or not the air quality is okay to breathe?
Our HAZMAT crew, they have certain air quality, but they probably will recommend the EPA come out here. Right now, like I said, as you said earlier, it's in HAZMAT level 3. That's a precautionary measure just to keep people safe. We've asked them to shelter in place, keeping their windows and doors closed. Right now, the fire is contained and seems to be under control. We can't determine what chemicals were in there until we're actually able to get inside the building. Right now, we've taken a defensive mode as opposed to an interior attack for the safety of the firefighters.
Okay, and again, you said you don't want to scare anybody, right. But if you are in this area, please reiterate for people what they should do.
If you are in this area close to the fire, and we're actually, this will be west, because the wind is blowing west right now, we're just asking the residents within, you know, several block radius, just please close their windows and doors, just to be safe.
All right. Thank you very much, Lieutenant. Jeff, Joanne, back to you.
Julie, just one more question for you there. We're saying Detroit's west side. Give us kind of an exact location where you are, because it could be seen from so far away, but where exactly is this?
Well, we're actually at the McGraw Street. Now, you can see it is Pittsburgh Street down here. This used to be an old U-Haul storage building, and residents in the area actually tell me before this, it was an old bakery.
Right, yeah, this Julie. Is really pretty close to I-94 in Livernois. That's on the west side. If you know where Kronk Gym is, just down the street from there. So once again, we'll stay on top of this story throughout the newscast here on WXYZ.com as well, just to give you any updates further tonight.
Yeah, thank you, Julie.